Excuse me, little dog. We're going to try this again. You guys will be absolutely shocked to hear that this is the second time I am starting the weekly Ain't Gonna Happen rant. Every week I get all of this shit organized and arranged and everything, and I go and I pick up my computer and I watch the entire screen disappear. It just happened again. We're gonna try this one more fucking time. And if it pulls this shit again, that's it. The Ain't Gonna Happen rant ain't gonna happen. But since it is Friday, what is it, October 11th, 2024, for the second time in an hour, we're going to bring you our Ain't Gonna Happen roundup rant. And where was I when all of this went to hell in a handbasket? So let's let the ATV parade go by here. Oh, Jesus. Oh, living with morons. Living with morons. How do we... Anyway, don't get me going on a living with morons rant. So if you saw my video last night that I did, it was about, I think, the World Wildlife Fund latest dying planet index. What I mentioned last night is what I've pretty much decided to do here at Collapse Chronicles is 6 days a week, I'm going to get an article out of the mainstream media or the alternative media or medium.com or whatever. And I'm going to sit here and read about this much stuff where whoever the author is talking about whatever subject about how fucked we are. You know, as I was saying, they go, we are so fucked. 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 But, and then they reach in their ass and pull this unadulterated horse shit, this, you know, this little Hollywood hopium happy horse shit that ain't gonna fucking happen, about how they're gonna turn it around. And this goddamn thing with of course these COP climate talks are a perfect example. But this thing, this World Wildlife Fund Dying Planet Index that I report on every year, every single year, or is it every 2 years or whatever, you know, that they come out every year or 2 years, and what they do is they turn the clock back 50 years and announce, okay, over the past 50 years, blank percent of our fellow earthlings have been obliterated off the face of the planet. That there's this percent less of our fellow earthlings than there were 50 years ago. So I think when I started doing this a few years ago, it was 66% that humans had obliterated 66% of our fellow earthlings off the face of the planet. I think I remember when it was at 70%. This year, wildlife numbers fall by 73% in 50 years. So every year, the number gets closer and closer to 100% of our fellow Earthlings that we have obliterated off the face of the planet. So they do all of this explaining why our fellow Earthlings are so fucked. Year after year, the numbers grow bigger and bigger and bigger as we get closer and closer to 100%. And then what they do in the last three paragraphs is they stick their head up their clueless fucking moron asses and start spewing this unadulterated horse shit. The same horse shit that we hear year after year. It's the same fucking horse shit that they were spewing when the number was 66%. It's the same horse shit that they were spewing when it was 70%. Now it's 73%. They're spewing the same fucking ain't gonna happen unadulterated horse shit that they've been spewing for years. It's pretty much verbatim. It is right out of the Hopium playbook. They know goddamn well, the World Wildlife Fund knows goddamn well that we're not going to do a goddamn thing to turn this train around, that that we get closer and closer to 100% of our fellow Earthlings, and we can do this over and over and over by these hopium addicts. You know, that jackass Johan Rockström over there on his TED Talk. The guy who invented the 9 planetary boundaries, talking about how we passed 6 of them, and then in the last 3 minutes, talking about how we're going to turn the fucking train around. And good fucking God. So we're literally going to pick up where we left off last night with the big butt. Assuming I can very carefully pick up this computer. Are you watching me? I am not touching this motherfucking computer. I'm not touching the fucking screen on the fucking computer. I'm not touching the fucking keyboard. I'm very carefully. Okay, we seem to have passed that. So we're literally going to pick up where we left off last night, and then we're going to go to where we were Wednesday night. All right. So, you know, like they do every year, this is from BBC News, talking about how wildlife numbers have fallen by 73% in the last 50 years, which, of course, is a ridiculously conservative number, hearing the Dying Planet Index. And then we get to the bottom. Valentina Macaroni from the Zoological Society of London's Institute of Zoology told BBC News the natural world was in a, quote, precarious position, but with urgent collective action from world leaders, quote, we still have the chance to reverse this. Yes, all it takes is urgent collective action from the same world leaders that they, anyway, this alarm call for the planet's wildlife comes as world leaders prepare to gather for the United Nations Biodiversity Conference in Colombia to discuss how to restore nature. Almost 200 countries have committed to a landmark. There we go, the landmark 2022 UN agreement to tackle nature loss, including setting aside 30% of the planet for nature by 2030. Okay. We get 70%. The humans get 70%. Every one of our the fellow Earthlings combined get 30. Humans, well, and their livestock get 70. Every other one of our fellow Earthlings gets 30% by 2030. What they fail to mention in this article, but they usually point out every year with these fucking bullshit biodiversity, is that every single biodiversity target that the United Nations has ever set, I'm pretty sure the number is 100% of these biodiversity save the planet, save our fellow Earthling targets, 100% failure rate. They're talking out of their ass more at these unadulterated horseshit biodiversity conferences than at the goddamn climate talks. Yes, the UK has signed up to the pledge, with the Foreign Secretary announcing the climate issue and decline in nature would be central to its government policy. Mr. Steele said the report was, quote, an incredible wake-up call. You know, which they've been having this incredible wake-up call probably for the last 50 years. I mean, Ms. Steele. Quote, healthy ecosystems underpin our health, prosperity, and well-being. We don't think this sits on the shoulders of the average citizen. It is the responsibility of business and of government. We need to look after our land and our most precious wild places for future generations. There is not one iota of evidence to show that biodiversity conferences are going to do one thing except to kick this can down the road as the number of our fellow Earthlings that we've obliterated off the face of this fucking planet gets closer and closer to 100% every year. All right, so if you can remember, as far back as Wednesday night, when I read a recap right there on Yahoo News, this excellent recap right there on Yahoo News from this outfit called Futurism, talking about this new study from Bioscience, the lead author, William Ripple, and all of these other folks signing on to it, it was the most hopium-free, spot-on, honest analysis I have ever read in the mainstream media about how fucked this planet is talking about this new study. They were looking at 35 indicators. It's not the planetary boundaries one. They were looking at, instead of 9, they were looking at 35 indicators of how fucked this planet is. In the year 2024, announcing that 25, we've already crossed 25 of them. We have 10 left to go before we are completely, irrevocably fucked. It was an absolute breath of fresh air. Not one mention of this happium horseshit that ain't going to happen. So I go on to bioscience. This is from Oxford University. Somehow attached to Oxford University, I think. Or the American Institute of Biological Sciences. Anyway, I don't know. It's all these guys mixed up. This outfit calling itself bioscience. And this study, the 2024 State of the Climate Report, Perilous Times on Planet Earth. And then, so William Ripple is the lead author, but then they have all of these other people that signed on to it, and I see among others, I see Michael Mann and Johan Rockström among the others, and I'm thinking, okay, if Michael Mann and Johan Rockström signed on to this, I guarantee you we're going to find the hopium. So anyway, what this is, the 2024 State of the Climate Report is this book-length, excellent chronicle of the collapse. It goes down the list. I guess there's 35, if you can. It goes right down the list, one after another. Okay, here we go. We are so fucked. 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 But maybe we're not so fucked. 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 25 out of 35, we're so fucked versus 10. Maybe we can turn this train around still. And anyone who loves charts and graphs and tables, I mean, they have done their homework. They talk all about ecological overshoot, the human enterprise, energy, greenhouse gases, ocean and ice, extreme weather, untold human suffering, coral bleaching, toxic rivers, solar radiation modification research, global temperatures, they get social justice in here, climate feedback loops, climate tipping points, and risk of social collapse, and then they get to the conclusions. And this might be where I was gonna read all of these things from medium.com, but I'm just gonna read the conclusions. 25, we're so fucked. 10, maybe we're not so fucked. Conclusions. Despite 6 IPCC reports, 28 COP meetings, hundreds of other reports, and tens of thousands of scientific papers, the world has made only very minor headway on climate change, in part because of stiff resistance from those benefiting financially from the current fossil fuel-based system. We are currently going in the wrong direction, and our increasing fossil fuel consumption and rising greenhouse gas emissions are driving us toward a climate catastrophe. We fear the danger of climate breakdown. The evidence we observe is both alarming and undeniable, but this is at the bottom of an article this big. We get to the but it is this very shock that drives us to action. We recognize the profound urgency of addressing this global challenge, especially the horrific outlook for the world's poor. We feel the courage and determination to seek transformative science-based solutions all across all aspects of society. Our goal is to provide clear, evidence-based insights that inspire informed and bold responses from citizens to researchers and world leaders, you know, talking about how the New World Order is chemtrailing hurricanes. You know, clear, evidence-based insights. Okay, so here we go. How about rapidly phasing down fossil fuel use should be a top priority? This might be accomplished partly through a sufficiently high global carbon price that could restrain emissions by the wealthy, yes, while potentially providing funding for much-needed climate mitigation and adaptation programs. In addition, pricing and reducing methane emissions is critical for effectively mitigating climate change. Methane is a potent greenhouse gas, and unlike carbon dioxide, which persists in the atmosphere, we've all heard this shit. Drastically cutting methane emissions can slow the near-term rate of global warming, helping to avoid tipping points and extreme climate impacts. Yes. In a world with finite resources, unlimited growth is a perilous illusion. We need bold, transformative change, drastically reducing overconsumption and waste, especially by the affluent, stabilizing and gradually reducing the human population. Wow. Through empowering education and rights for girls and women. There you go. We're just going to stabilize, then gradually reduce the human population through empowering education and rights for girls and women. And now we move on to reforming food production systems to support more plant-based eating and adopting an ecological and post-growth economics framework that ensures social justice. Climate change instructions should be integrated into secondary and higher education, core curriculum worldwide to raise awareness, improve climate literacy, and empower leaders to take action. We also need more immediate efforts to protect, restore, or rewild ecosystems. The surge in yearly climate disasters shows we are in a major crisis with worse to come if we continue business as usual. Today, more than ever, our actions matter. Our actions matter for the stable climate system that has supported us for thousands of years. Humanity's future depends on our creativity, moral fiber, and perseverance. We must urgently reduce ecological overshoot and pursue immediate, large-scale climate change mitigation and adaptation to limit near-term damage. Only through decisive action can we safeguard the natural world, avert profound human suffering, and ensure that future generations inherit the livable world they deserve. The future of humanity hangs in the balance. Can you hear the mouse chewing? You get that mousey light out. That mousey is up there chewing. That mousey light out. Right over the camera light out. Guys, you know, I was gonna go over here to medium.com and read more of this shit. I'm just getting fed up with it. Every goddamn word of that is unadulterated. Ain't gonna happen. The hopium happy horse shit. Nothing more. Not a goddamn word of that is gonna happen. There is not one scintilla of evidence that one word of that that shit that they just spewed out at the end of their 25 "we are so fucks" is gonna happen. We're gonna go straight through 26 to 35 of their categories. We're gonna go straight through the last three of Johan Rockström's planetary boundaries. We're gonna go right on obliterating 100% of our fellow Earthlings off the face of this planet. Hopefully, starting with that motherfucking mouse chewing here on the wall of this tiny house. Anyway, looks like it's time for Sandy's show on a environmental coffee house, so I'm gonna go join the warm and fuzzy side of the doomosphere. We call Sandy the Madam Butterfly of the doomosphere, so I'm gonna shut my grouchy old self up, and we're gonna go let the Madam Butterfly of the doomosphere get us all warm and fuzzy on this cold autumn night. Get out there and get all warm and fuzzy while you still can. I have my warm fuzzy bathrobe. I have my warm fuzzy pajamas. I have my warm fuzzy Uggs. I'm just a warm and fuzzy kind of guy. And I got my warm and fuzzy little dog who needs to get that warm and fuzzy little mouse and a wall like that. Oh my gosh.
What do you think, little warm and fuzzy doggy? You getting the mousey or not?
That mousey. He's right behind the snow leopard. We have a mousey attacking the snow leopard.